You want cereal? A lot? Oh, okay. I didn't put the milk in. Yeah, cereal's ready. All right, I'll bring.
Why?
You know you have to do a reading, right? You're gonna take this book with you to school. Thing done. And there's things you're gonna be doing on Saturday. And that's how I'm gonna let you play a video game on Saturdays. Only after you come from the thing. Okay, don't take too long to eat. Today is September, I believe, either 16 or 17. September 16 or 17, 2016. It's a Friday. I'll check later. I haven't posted much on my fitness channel. I've been really busy pretty much since this year. Since January, I've been very busy with some legal stuff and then the summer came, you know, I had the kids. I had to, you know, even though I was going through some legal issues, I had to get the kids out, make them do things. I didn't want them to consume with my problem, even though I don't tell them about my problem, but I didn't want my problem affect their, you know, from enjoying the summer. So I haven't posted much, but I have, when I take them out, you know, I'll use my cell phone to record some of the things that they've done, that they are doing. And in terms of fitness, there are so many things I wanted to do with them over the summer, and I didn't do it. So I'm kind of bummed about it, but I'm hoping the legal stuff stop right now, to tell you the truth, because there's also another video that I did regarding the legal things, and I'm gonna post it on the fitness channel because it had to do with the gym that I used to go to. So I will be posting it. I will be posting it pretty much. So I don't want to talk too much about this because there's one video that's going to be about it. I just need to take time, go over some of the things that I want to put out. And I think it will be very helpful for some of, for the young people who's going and who's starting into fitness and some shady thing that some gym owners are doing once you give them your credit card. So I had gone to court twice, and the third time, if they're messing up with me, I'm gonna take a lawyer, because I did not really want them to go to jail, but I wanted to sort of let them know that, you know, I know what they're doing, even though they will not, you know, do the right thing. So I had to take them to court. This is gonna be a separate video, and I've done it. There's one portion that I've done. I did not publicize it yet, but it's up on YouTube. But basically, this video is gonna be. I decided to do this video to talk about why I haven't really posted much on my fitness channel. Because yesterday, while I was at the gym, a lady, you know, I usually say hi to, and I've complimented her on her progress and things like that. But nothing major. I don't know her personally, but I will say hi to her and give her some sort of encouragement. Not telling her lies, because I've seen the improvement on her from the time I started going to when I started seeing the improvement. So I told her what I've seen and to pretty much encourage her, to give her a boost and continue her thing, because she hires a trainer at the facility. So pretty much it's just to encourage her. And she does, she has improved. In my eyes, I've seen some improvement. So yesterday, for the first time, when I was in the locker room, you know, I said hi to her again, and then we started talking. Both of us had finished our workout. So I went to wash my hands so I could eat some of the cookies that I usually make, those oatmeal cookies. So I wanted to wash my hands before I start eating it. So when I was in the locker room, we started talking, and one thing led to another, and I told her about my YouTube channel and things like that. So pretty much while I was talking to her, on back of my head, I remember what was going on my previous gym. You know, I started working out with some people, not training them, but they wanted to work out with me. So in back of my head, that's what I was thinking. And I was like, I don't even want to say what, I don't want to work out with people that I know who has hired trainers at the gym, because I don't want the gym to think that I'm taking their customers away, even though I'm not personally training anybody. But some people wants to work out with me. Not that I know everything, but from the previous gym, I know what had happened. People seen how I changed, and they sort of like how my body have transformed to. So many of them wants to work out with me. So in back of my, that's what had happened in the previous gym. So in the new gym, now that I was talking to her, and I'm telling myself, make sure I don't work out with anybody that I know who has hired trainers at that gym. So they don't think that I'm taking their customers or I'm making money off of their back, because that was the concept that the old gym thought that I was doing. So that's what I was thinking. If she's watching this video, because I told her my channel. So that's what I was thinking as I was talking to her. And she was asking me about nutritional stuff, what I eat and things like that. So when she first asked me, I told her, you know, I think these are questions I think you should ask your trainer, because I'm not a personal trainer. But I know, so I sort of explained to her what works for me. And I told her about my oatmeal cookies, how I came about to, you know, making them. Because one day before workout, I ate some oatmeal. And I realized, and I didn't take any pre-workouts or anything like that. So when I was working out, I realized how much energy that I had, and that's how I came about making those oatmeal cookies. I realized, because I pretty much write everything that I eat, so I know it was the oatmeal that gave me the energy. So from that, because I love oatmeal cookies, from that I decided to make the oatmeal cookies, and I realized the same thing happened when I ate the oatmeal cookies. And I had the energy again. So from that point on, I start adding my supplements within the oatmeals. I don't give my kids that particular oatmeal. I'll make two separate batch, one without the supplements and one with the supplements. So I was explaining to her all this stuff. So for those oatmeal cookies that I eat, I put my supplements, creatine, protein, and what was it, glutamine. And I don't really need to take those, creatine separately, or the the protein separately after workout or anything like that. So everything is in the cookies and it works for me. All I need is two of those cookies and I'll eat it before I work out. And after workout, I'll eat two of those cookies again because they have all the supplements in it. And if I'm really hungry, I'll eat four. So in one bag, I'll put four cookies, but technically I only need two. And depending on how hungry I am by the time I get home, so I don't eat junk food if things are not prepared, I'll eat four. So I was telling her about it, and I told her how I made it. I make it with banana, and I told her the softer the banana, the better because I don't put any sugar, so the sugar come from the bananas and things like that. So we started talking, and I felt like I should put this video. Why I haven't been putting videos. Not only I'm a mom, I need to do a couple of things at home, get the kids ready and things like that. So today, the minute I got up, I was thinking about maybe I should make a video of what I do in the morning. So here it is. It's not the entire day, actually, it's 9:30 in the morning. I just finished do some vacuuming and things like that, clean the bathroom. The day is not even over yet, but I'm just gonna show partial of my days and what I've done so far. And I'm gonna edit this video right now. So if you like this video, share, like, subscribe, do all this stuff. But let me get back to work. What else do I need to do? Oh, I have a friend of mine who wants to give my son some trains. And I told her on my way back from the gym, I'll stop by her house to pick it up. And I'm not going to the gym today. So I have to call her before I pick up my kids to go get it. And then maybe some of the rest. Okay, the camera's on. So let me get back to work. Michael? Michael? Yep. Get up. Good morning.
Hello.
Guess what today is?
Friday.
Yay! All right, so we need to get ready, okay? Don't take too long to come down, okay? All right, come down. It's what? 7:12. Okay. This little guy, he could still sleep a little bit longer because the house is a mess. They left all this last night. Books everywhere. Yo. Why you didn't clean up after you did all your writing last night? You need to get up, okay? Silly boy. Yes. Wow, this guy really put a lot of paper in there. I should have got a mug for myself too. At least the yellow. The M&M mugs. It looks kind of comfy to drink tea. Why stuff your mouth? Finish it, go brush your teeth, right? Are you happy today's Friday? Yes. All right, you, come on. Today's a half a day.
I know, but I'm not that happy if you look at like that, because it's almost like the other days, because it's almost like it's the end, really, like on Monday.
It's still Tuesday. The same. It feels the same as the other days.
Yes, because it's almost at the end. It just has one more thing.
Well, which one you rather? You rather do that one extra thing or not do the extra thing?
I do not want to do that.
All right, so they did that because the principal need to speak with the teachers. I spoke to the principal last year when I went to some meetings. They want to... She wants to speak with the teachers and see how you guys are doing, what things they need help with, so they never have time. So in order to create the time, she gives you guys that extra, they let you guys out early so she could speak with the teachers on Friday. So because the teachers, you know, they have their own lives too. They need to, some of them probably have kids, so... She can't keep on holding them at school to talk to them when they have their own lives, you know, to take care of. You have a huge booger in your nose.
I know.
So take it out. That's nasty. Exactly. Don't put it on top of your food. It might fall in there and you eat it. That's yucky.
What's that mean?
Yucky? That means it's no good.
No good.
All right, finish up and let's get ready. 7:30 already. Something. Yes.
I still
want
to do something to you.
What do you want to do? I hope it's a good thing. You want to talk to me, right?
Yeah.
Talk.
What's that stuff in Michael's nose?
Boogers. You see when you keep going... Like this with your nose, when it becomes dry, it becomes kind of hard in your nose, and sometimes it stick out. It looks yucky on your nose. Don't dig up your nose. All right, get up. Go brush your teeth.
Is that good?
To clean your nose, it's good to clean your nose. All right, guys, come on. Thank you for cleaning up. You think you could pick up these too? Because I can't bend. Thank you so much. These goes in, you know where they go, in the toy box in the room. Take that bucket. There's that bucket in there. Put them in there so you don't make 2,000 trips.
Oh.
There's most... Well, go ahead. Luigi?
Because I was drawing Mario, and then he knows how
to draw. Use that hand to hold the paper. You and Michael have a bad habit. So
no,
I'll
he
just...
was doing that, but I told him to stop because I wanted to draw the paper.
You drew this? Oh, my God. If you didn't do it in front of me, I would not know you did it. But it's so light. Wow. Michael, you're a good teacher. What? If I didn't see this, I would think Michael did that.
Whoa.
Let me see.
But it's very, very light. Look.
Wow, I can't see nothing.
Yeah, it's very light, but you could make up the face. Sun? No, the he flower? Draw. Don't erase.
Michael!
No,
leave him. Let him draw his face. All right. He draw a face, a smiley face and everything.
I'm a flower, I thought.
No. That's the circle.
Yeah, and then flower leaves around it.
What flower leaves? No, it's a face with a
hat. He's trying to draw a hat, but that's not really how.
It's
nice,
good.
Nice, Mark, nice.
Wow. It's very light, but I could...
Michael, let's get your shoes on. You ate your gum?
Where's your gum?
Did you eat gum yet?
There's nothing in there. Oh, there's over there. All right.
You take one, start eating now, and then you eat one on the way there. Put it in your pocket, one.
You need to wear the other sweater. I'm wondering if he could wear the hoodie
once. He could
once,
wear the hoodie. Just wear the hoodie.
Yeah, wear the hoodie. Because it's...
Mommy, you sure look. He doesn't want a belt?
Go down.
You ready for school?
Yeah. Okay, now you have to put some...
Oh, wow. He did draw the gum like it's a...
And then he has to draw some spikes, or little spikes, or should I do that for him?
No, let him do it. Okay. I would not think... If he did this in school and they send it home, I would not believe it. Mark.
That's a Luigi.
That's Luigi?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually a nice hat. Wait, why did you put M? Because it's supposed to be...
It's Mario. L. So that's Mario. L for Luigi.
So what did you get?
Oh, I think he was copying yours. This one. He put a M. Is that what you did?
Yeah. And how do we make that?
That? You just have to do an oval, put spikes, and then do this. That's easier. So let me just test.
How old are you, Mark? How old are you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Yes, four.
How many fingers I have?
Four.
Count. Michael, be quiet when I ask him.
One, two, three, four.
So you think 4 years old? Draw four.
Can you draw number four for me? You could put it next to the gum you were drawing. Do number four. We need to work on how you hold your pencil, but for now it's okay.
You see that? Draw that over there?
I'm listening.
No, I don't want to say it.
Whatever. Wait. What?
I'll draw.
Very good. Okay, let me start. Very good. Now it's becoming easier for you. Look how quick you did it. You didn't need to pick up the pencil. All right, next one. K, it has to be next to it to make the word. No, you can't put, if you put it by itself, it's something else. And you need to press harder on the pencil. We can't see it.
I can't see it.
Yeah, but other people need to see it. But very good. Very, very good. You did the number four, which is very light.
I will make K even lighter.
But you need to press harder. I'm proud of you, Mark. I'm very proud of you. You're going to write your name again at school? Very good.
I will try another one like this.
Okay. When I come back, I'll clean.
Ooh. What's the word that?
They call Ajax to clean.
Ajax?
Yeah. Alright. When I come back, I'll clean it. You guys made a whole bunch of mess. Okay, I have to make sure I have my wallet. My desk is a mess. Go.
I want to get the gum out.
Alright, put it in your pocket or just leave it here.
I just want to leave it here.
Alright, so yeah, put it on my desk. Let's go. Okay, make sure I have my keys. Close the door before I realize. Alright. You have to go on? Alright, wait until she... You could say excuse me? Okay, wait until she's gone. Wait until she's gone, okay? All of them. Okay. Okay, your turn. What?
Oh wow.
By yourself now? Oh my goodness.
What?
You were swinging over?
So everybody left?
Just you. Go ahead. Oh, somebody else is coming. Oh, there's more. Yeah, I want to go off again. Show me your skills. Oh my goodness. And they back. Still just you. Go ahead. Show me how you write your name again. Try not to wet your face. Yeah, that's good. Oh, I don't know what they are. I don't care about it. Don't worry about it. Dry your hand.
No, I don't
know. Dry your hand really well. Very good. Get more. Because you don't want to... I need to bring you toothbrush and toothpaste. I have to get that for you. Where's yours? Yeah, I need to bring yours.
Everybody has toothpaste.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, I'll bring yours. Let's go. Can you show me how you write your name again? Let's look for it. Okay, why don't you sit here? Sit here. Mark. Yeah, this time she wants you to follow the thing. Go ahead. Let me see you do it. Go ahead. Sit down.
Okay, one more time. Come with me. I'm going to give you a marker and do it one more time.
Start with the first one on top.
If you want to do a crayon, you can do. You want to make sure bring your baby here.
Go ahead.
Your baby.
Follow the dot.
Draw me a nice picture. Come with him. For you, it's pretty, to the other table. Crayons are here. Scarlett.
How about this one?
Isiana, sit down, big.
You know there's two faces here, right?
Yeah, I just saw they hang them over there. Nice.
What about this thing?
Yeah, okay. Why don't you write it without doing this? Let me see you write it by yourself. Go ahead.
I won't do that.
All right, do it. Because you've done it before. Yes, I see it. But you've written without the dot before. Yeah?
Is it okay?
Okay? Can you do it now? She wants you to write it here without the dot. Can you do it? Go ahead. Start right here. Start right here.
No, Papa.
That you know. She wants you to do the small.
Right here.
Okay,
right here. Okay, pa?
Sí, te tengo.
Dame mi beso. Yo tengo un corito, okay, pa?
Good.
Mi beso. I love you.
Okay,
te bendiga, mi amor.
You want a big pencil or a skinny pencil?
Mira.
How about this pencil?
Trace it and then you do it, okay?
Chulo. Okay.
Hello.
Very good, I gotta go. Mwah. Good job.
Wait, mommy.
Huh?
What thing?
Do it, Papi, do it.
Oh, and eat.
Right,
Papi. Oh, you don't. Oh, you wanna write your last name? Go ahead. But do it next to it. Thank you. finish, and then grind back. So now I'm back home after dropping my little guy to school. I need to clean up now. So let's see how I do it. Fast forward. This sponge that I clean the sink with, only the top of this I clean, because this is the one that people touch the most. But clean the sink, clean the toilet. I leave this for a little while so at least it get disinfected. This I'm gonna leave it for a little while and then I'm gonna rinse it. I have two different sponges. This one that I use for the toilet around the bowl is yellow, and the one that I use for the sink is blue. What I normally do is that in the kitchen, when I use, this is what I use to wash the plates. I have a dishwasher, but it takes too long and we don't have that many plates when I cook, so I just wash it by hand. So I always have two different colors, both in the bathroom and the kitchen. So this one is the newest one. I use it to wash the plates and bowls and whatever. And then when the sponge is about to finish, is deteriorating, I switch it. Like for instance, last time, this blue one was for the when I washed the plates. So when it started to rip apart, I switch it. I put the new one for the sink. And it's always two different colors. And I use this one to clean around the sink, the stove and things like that. And when it's almost gone, or if anything, I will use that one for the bathroom, either for the sink or for the floor. It depends. But the newer, whenever I open a new sponge, it always goes for the plate. The plates always have the newer one. The dishes always have the newer sponge. And then whatever I was using for the sponge is used to clean the stove. And if, for instance, I need a new sponge for the bathroom, I'll take whatever that I was using for the to clean the sink and the stove, I'll use it for the bathroom. Unless if I really need one right away, I'll, you know, depend on whatever I need, I'll use it for the switch the sponge around. But the plates always have the new ones. So now I'm gonna clean the floor. My kids are dirty. Dirty little boys. Every 2 days. I don't clean every day. It's probably every 2 days or something like that. So now I need to clean the floor, and I'm gonna leave this like that for a while. And then when I'm gonna rinse it, I'm gonna wet it a little bit, but it's gonna be dry and a little bit hard when I'm ready to clean to rinse it. And I'm gonna scrub it one more time, and then it's gonna be really nice. And now I'm gonna clean the floor. I use that towel. I'm tired of buying mops. As you can see, the red thing that I used to brush the tub, I use it twice and it broke, but I found out that the brush is helpful, so I kept the stick to brush the tub with it. And I use this green rag towel to clean the floor. But I spent, it's like almost every, I would say maybe every 2 weeks, I have to buy a new mop. I could never find a good mop. So I left it alone. I just, because my house is mostly carpet. And I'm going to vacuum in a few. It's mostly carpet. I only need the mop for the bathroom and the kitchen. And none of the mops that I buy are good enough. They're always breaking. So I give up. So I just use an old rag or something to clean the floor. So now I'm gonna vacuum. This morning when I got up, I was shocked to see all those papers on the floor, but I made them clean most of it before we left, before they went to school. So one thing that we've done, actually, to save papers, I was telling a friend of mine the other day about that. Before, when we buy papers, you know, for the printer and things like that. We have some down here. And one of the stack of papers will be gone within a week because of my kids. They'll be drawing and put one line on a piece of paper and then it's gone. It's in the trash. And they will not use the back of it. So I got tired of spending money on buying papers, and when I need them to print stuff, I don't have any in the house. So what I told my husband, because he works in an architecture firm, and I told him, because I used to work for a firm, for architecture firm myself, so I know we use a lot of papers. Sometimes after you finish draw something, before you send the project out, you need to print it and to check to see if everything is correct. It's completely different when you're seeing it on the screen and then you have a hard copy in front of you. So this is a couple projects that he worked on. He may not even work on these. Yeah, that's his work. So he probably did some of these here. So when I told him papers that they don't need, and if they have stacks of papers that they're gonna throw away, bring them here so the kids could use the back of the papers to draw. So as you can see, we have a whole bunch here. They draw whatever they need to do on the back. And then once they're done, we just toss it. That's one way of recycling. So we have a couple of papers here. So whenever they need, they just grab it. They don't even need to ask us for papers. Just grab them and do whatever they need to do. And this morning, I think I saw my son doing some drawings Yeah, they make a mess. They clean the, at least they clean the floor. I don't have to bend down. So they were drawing. This is my little guy, my youngest, drew this. I was kind of surprised to see him draw this. And this is my oldest who drew this. So yeah, this is the front of the paper from the printout from my husband's job. I hope I didn't show the name of the firm in there. And then they use the back. There it is. And that's how I save. That's how we save money from not buying papers. So I hope that gives you guys an idea yourself when you guys if you have kids, because if I dare throw these away right now, I'm in trouble once they come home. They're going to ask me for their work. So I keep it for a little while until they forget about it, and then I toss it. They have so many junk papers, and each time I want to throw them away, they scream at me. They want me to save their drawings. So now I'm going to do a quick vacuum, and then there's some work I need to do on the computer. And let's get going. One thing that I always keep in mind when I live in a small apartment is to get foldable furnitures. Like for instance this chair, let me put the camera down. This chair, fold it. My other chairs, this one, fold it. Okay? So when you need space, you just fold it and put it away. So most of my furniture are, you know, you can fold them. Even the table here, because I have stuff here, I don't feel like folding it right now. These are my kids' books and stuff. They have so many junk, and each time I touch them, they scream. In my eyes, I want to throw everything away. The other day, I had to go over. I had to make my son, my youngest, go over some of his last year's schoolwork with me. I think I have a video on it. I don't know which thing that I posted on. Some mangoes here that's about to go bad. I need to eat them before I completely lose them. So I'm gonna peel two of them before I pick my kids from school. I peel them so I could take the garbage with me when I'm going downstairs to get them. So I have my mangoes here. I have this plastic bag where I'm gonna put the mango peel, and I like to use this flat plate to cut things like a cutting board, and it will make it easier for me. So I'm gonna peel it. That will be like a snack for me. This morning, for some reason, I got up. I'm not really that hungry. I only drank some coffee, and that was it. I didn't eat anything. I didn't go to the gym. And it is still September 16. I'm editing the video that I'm going to be putting this in. And I already have some footage that I'm working on. And then before I pick up the kids from school, time is just flies. You don't even know what you do all day, and it's already done. So I'll be recording a couple stuff, whatever I feel like is worth putting in that in today's video, I'll put it. Otherwise, most likely I'm not gonna kill myself with it. But the main part that I really wanted to talk about, which is about the gym and things that I've been doing, why I haven't been posting much, and I've already added some pictures and things, and those court, those trial videos, I think is going to be very helpful to many people. I think that's where I am now in editing the videos. And like I said, there's a lot of, not too much, maybe two or three videos that I've already posted, but I uploaded, not posted. I upload into my fitness channel, but I never made them public because I know those gym people are on my feed. Because they tried to use my YouTube channel against me. I have to laugh about it because it's a silly channel. Some of the videos, it's so weird because during the trial, their lawyer tried to bring it up. And I was like, yeah, I have a YouTube channel because I was the one who told him about it. And because people were asking me questions and I didn't want to train people, and I'm not a trainer. So many people were asking me questions. I had to create the channel, and it wasn't, I already had a channel, but it wasn't about fitness. But since so many people were asking me questions of what I do, what I eat, and there's people still asking me about it. And so it was easy for me to answer the question by just putting some videos up. And I don't kill myself to put the videos up. I just record whatever I was doing and just post them. And most of them don't even have instruction, except one video, maybe one or two video, where a friend of mine, who actually doesn't even live in the state that I am in, who asked me a question. And since I've been doing it for myself, and I decided to put it, put that particular video up. So they were trying to use my video, my channel, against me. And I was like, because I'm going to put all the trial audio on online on the YouTube channel. You guys could hear it. It's a long trial. The first one was very long. So I think maybe about 2 hours worth. And the second one, I'm not even going to mention anything on this right now because something fishy went on. But I just decided to let it go. I wasn't really after their money in the first place. But something, it just created so many things. If these people didn't have connection, there's no way some of the things they're getting away with were happening. But I probably gonna cut this part out because I don't wanna say anything beyond that. But they were trying to use the YouTube channel against me, and the thing is that, like I was telling someone at the gym the other day, when you tell the truth, you could wake me up in the middle of the night and you ask me the same question, the truth is gonna come out. I had absolutely no reason whatsoever for me to go to court and lie. But these people, it's weird. But anyway, I'm preparing my snack before I pick up my kids from school. And I didn't want to leave the mango skin in the house. So that's why I'm doing this. Oh, geez, it's already 6 minutes. I didn't want the video to be long. So that's my snack. I got caught up talking about the trial. But anyway, this is my snack for the day. I didn't, for some reason, today I'm not that hungry. Which is good because this past couple of days, I've been eating like crazy. Not like crazy, but things that I should not be eating. My stomach's a little bit, you can see. It's not that bad compared to some people. I'm not complaining too much, but I know it changed because of what I've eaten. So I just need to control. So that's my snack. Healthy snack. And I'm gonna show you guys the final product. I cut them into little slices. I'm gonna put them in a bowl. And while I'm editing, what time is it now? Now it's 12:40. And my son has a half a day today. So I better hurry up. The bowl, I'm gonna put it in. Almost dropped them. I'm trying to make sure. I'm using my cell phone, so it's standing. I don't know. My husband bought this, the stick for me to put the cell phone in, on. So there it is. That's my snack. Let me see how sweet this is. It's good. Anyway, I might put this part in the video, in today's video. This is what Svetlana gave you this. Go bring it in the living room. I'll be right there. Go open it. I'll be right there. Take it with you. I have to. Yeah. You have to change your clothes.
Is that food?
No.
What does that mean?
Can you hold this? You like it?
Yes.
That's a lot of tracks. The wooden one. Which one you like better? The Thomas one or this one?
This one.
You sure?
Yes.
Alright. So, let me go help Michael.
Okay.
And we have to change your clothes. You can't stay with that clothes. Okay?
This thing?
Both of them. Oh. Your pants and your shirt. Alright, let me help Michael.
Okay.
Dog.
Why is your... Mommy?
Yep.
Why is your phone recording nothing?
Can you bring it to me, please?
And Scott and Pro.
Mommy, I don't know why the bridge is doing nothing.
Which one
are
you doing?
What is that? That? I don't
look know. At the picture. What is it?
I don't know. That's why I'm sure. Blanket?
Blanket? What's a blanket?
I'm not understanding this.
Well, try all of this and see which one sounds better. Sounds good. Start with the F and go around.
Now
I need to break this in half.
Say it out loud first before you write.
Mommy.
Blanket. No. Blanket. Yeah.
Oh. What about it?
Blanket.
Oh, I forget it.
Okay. Okay, blanket, good.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think this is?
Look
at the picture. What do you think it is? All right, make the sounds and see what.
Scale. Scale.
What is that? What's that like? O?
No, that's a C.
It looks like an O.
Yeah.
So you say it properly, but you put the wrong thing.
No, right.
Okay, now it looks like a C. I'm looking at the drum. Scale. Okay, that's it for Friday's thing?
Are you sure? Yes.
Oh, there's more. There's the math. Oops, sorry. Oh, let me get you the chair. You need chair?
Yeah.
So you have to read. Can you write? Listen. Not listen. Read the instruction and see what you have to do.
Okay.
I'm gonna get
the meow cow.
The parrot. Read it. Read it all over again.
the parrot house and 6 adult macaws and 9 young macaws. How many macaws does it have in all?
When you hear the word all, what do you think it tells you to
do? It means it's plus.
Okay, so go ahead.
First there was 6.
Oh, not why like the that. Number?
I know, I'm like, not like that.
You're spelling it, but, okay.
6, 9. Okay, now, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 15.
All right, you got it, okay? I'll check it later. Good job.
The down, no. Under, pools.
Shallow pools. Okay, where is it? 2 large shallow pools hold 7 white rhinos and 6 black rhinos. How many rhinos are there? So they put this number as a trick. Now, they're asking you for how many of what? Is it pools or rhinos?
Yeah. Rhinos.
Good. So how many is the first one? How many rhinos on the first one?
7, like
okay, so okay, 7 should be on the one, and then, and how many on the next, in the 6, next one?
6.
6, okay.
Can I drink something?
Not yet, because you just drink that milk. Give yourself some time before you drink the orange juice, okay?
Okay.
Otherwise, you might throw up.
In the monkey house, there are 8 tamarins and 6 mimes. 6 marmalades. How many monkeys are there in all?
Oh, they put the signs for you. You don't have to worry. Okay. Do your thing. Let me go help Mark.
How many monkeys are there? It's a fish a day. How many baskets of fish do they eat in 2 days? I guess it's 2.
No. Read carefully. Read it again.
The seals eat 8 baskets of fish a day. How many baskets of fish do they eat in 2 days?
Okay. So, in 1 day, how many do they eat? How many fish do they eat in 1 day?
8.
8, right? Now, in 2 days, so how many will there be in the next day? How many fish will they eat the next day?
8.
That's right.
So 8 plus 8.
Exactly. Very good.
Equals 16.
Very good. So you have to read the thing carefully. Put your name.
What are these? I don't know. Wait, I know. It's for those lightning things.
You just use your imagination. Do whatever you want.
Wait, am I supposed to write my name on the other side?
Right, whatever. And then you have to do reading. Did you bring this? Over-counter medication.
It's been on this side. Now I gotta do my... reading. Now I do. Which page should I read to?
Where's the book?
The book is up there.
Read the next. Move your shoulders so you don't mess up the paper.
No.
All right. You are going to read. Okay. You read chapter 1. So I want you to read chapter 2. If you have to go in the room to read. Wait.
People sit to watch the train.
You know what? This tells you where it ends. Up to page 17, I think. Oh, no. That was... Yeah. But what happened here? Did you read chapter 2? Oh, no. 17 and then 25, I think. There. You read up to 25. And most of it are pictures. Okay? And then you put this on the page 25. Alright?
Okay.
And then after that, you could play video again. And then you're done for this week. Remember, tomorrow, we have to go somewhere.
And then I could play.
Yes. Good job. One thing I like to add is that over the summer, after doing a couple activities with the family, I think I went a little bit crazy. I went overboard. I created 2 additional YouTube channels. As a total of 4 channels. That's MA Paris, that's for family stuff. And I'll put all those links to those channels in the description. So I have MA Paris that pretty much things about my things that I do with the kids, family stuff. And I have MA Paris Fitness that's about exercise and exercise that I've done. So these 2 channels, I had them for a while. But those 2 new ones that I created was during, I take the kids out, we went on vacation, and I realized I'm recording a couple stuff, and I decided to separate each one. I think that's a bit crazy. Maybe I should just keep one channel. But those 2 channels are, that's MA Paris Roads, R-O-A-D-S. That's when we're on the road, we're in the car, while we're driving, we say things, pretty much driving to certain places. So I'll have that. Or when we're walking to certain places, sometimes I record little things and little conversations we have. So I'll be putting these on the roads channel. And the other channel that I create, I believe it's called MA Paris Family Adventures. So we went hiking. And I thought, oh, that would be better to put this separate for outdoor things. So I decided to create MA Paris Family Adventures. I think that's what I call it. I'll put that in the description box. So when we go out, for instance, we went hiking. When I have time, I'll edit that video and I'll put that. And I did record those hiking things with the kids. And when we go, swimming, I'll be putting the swimming stuff, things that I did with the kids, when outdoor things, pretty much. So there are 4 channels. MA Paris is general family things, and I have MA Paris Fitness. I do my fitness exercise things, that'll be in that. And I have MA Paris Roads, that things that I do going to certain places when I work with the kids. If I record them, I'll put those things on that channel. And I have MA Paris Family Adventures. So it's things when we go on vacation, things that we do together. If I feel like they're worth sharing, then I'll put that on the channel. So all the channels will be in the description. And I hope you guys follow me, subscribe to those channels, and hopefully they are interested too.